any other questions with the research of Professor Vasilianis, that's Professor of Electrical and Computer Engineering at the University of West Macedonia, who will present his research about the carry look head adder, which is a digital circuit that is used in an electronic and computation device to improve speed calculation. Please, Professor Vasilianis, can share the screen.
Thank you very much for your introduction, Professor Fragoulis. As you have heard, my name is Minas Vasilianis. I'm an assistant professor at the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. And you can see my share, I think. You don't have any problem. I'm going
everything to... Everything is okay.
Okay, then I continue. You know, I like to hear some feedback when I give my presentation because technology mishap happens and perhaps sometimes screens get hung. So without further ado, I'm going to present my research work with my team named A Generator Tool for Carry Look Ahead Adders. So as we saw in the title, the word adder is used. Perhaps some of you are from another background, not from hardware or IT. So I'm going to give a few words about what is an adder. An adder is a fundamental component. Every laptop, mobile, workstation, embedded system carries a central processing unit called CPU. The most fundamental component is the adder that performs the addition. The addition and subtraction. Traditional adders are the high ripple carry adders in which a carry follows a long carry chain, resulting in a latency, which is equal to the number of bits. Carry look ahead adders speed up this computation. Of course, the trade-off is an increased hardware and increased complexity. And here is where our contribution lies. We try to alleviate this complexity for the designer and the students, as I'm going to show in the next slide, in order to help them utilize this very useful component. So the carry look ahead adder, as I already discussed, it improves the speed calculation, namely the latency between receiving the input and computing the output of the addition or the subtraction by reducing the time required to define carry bits. What it does, it breaks the long chain of computations of ripple carry into a more defined chain. CLA is a very important building block for any digital circuits. It is used in every CPU that requires high performance. It's an arithmetic module. It performs the addition and the subtraction. And sometimes it can also be used to perform multiplication if we combine the addition of multiple sub-products. Okay. It's a very important module. Let's have a bit of a schematic what is a ripple carry adder. As you can see, and I'm pointing you on the slide on the left side, we have the classic ripple carry adder in which we have to add two inputs, the A input consisting of four bit, A0, A1, A2, and A3, and the B input consisting of B0, B1, B2, and B3. It's an addition of 2 4 bit vectors. So we are using a 1-bit full adder, and the problem is that every full adder creates a carry that has to be forwarded to the next level of full adder, which then produces a carry which also has to be forwarded to the next full adder, and so on. For 4 bits, we can see that the carry should travel 4 full adders. If we have larger bit widths, for example, our current era of CPU is 64 8-bit architecture, it means that we have to travel 64 bits. And I cannot tell you that on the CPU, there are very large registers that carry many more bits than 64, like vector registers that can hold, for example, 256 bits. This means that the latency rises to a level that prohibits the high throughput. For this reason, the carry look-ahead adder was designed. The theoretical background of how it is designed, where it's going to be displayed on the next slide. But the key issue is that we don't have this chain. For example, you can see that every full ladder sends some bits to a card generation network. And this card generation network can be utilized to compute the carry bit. For example, the carry bit here, the carry bit one is computed in a few cycles and is inputted to the next full ladder without having a large chain. Of course, this is a very complicated circuit. The module that is added on the right, as you can see, is consists of many gates and exponentially has a great increase in hardware. So this is a trade-off. We all know that nothing is free in the hardware domain. You can gain some performance, but you have to pay in hardware. But given the fact that we have billions of transistors in an integrated circuit, it's hardware that we can pay. It's hardware that we can utilize to achieve better performance. So the difficult part is how to design this module, not only for 4 bits, but for an arbitrary number of bits. And usually students, because I have taught in the past digital design, they are not used to design such complex things. They just see a couple of pages of how the equations of each bit is found, and they just use it as a black box without going further, without diving in this module. And this motivated me to create this tool with my PhD students, in order to give the students and engineers that would like to utilize a custom CLA adder for their design a possibility to design this module. This module is designed in VHDL, VHDL, which is a hardware description language, along with Verilog and System Verilog, are used to define the hardware architecture of today's integrated circuits. CLA is a very important module. First of all, it's taught on every digital design course, on every university. It's very difficult to design. As I saw you, it consists not only from the others, but with a network of propagate and generate carries. It's essential for high performance because we break the chain of the carry propagation, and we can achieve the same computation in a very low number of cycles. Students do not utilize CLA because it's a very complex component, and also engineers usually utilize library components which limit their flexibility. For example, these libraries have a fixed number of bits, and if an engineer would like to utilize a different number of bits, he cannot do it because a generator is lacking. My tool can be used to generate CLAs for an arbitrary bit length. Of course, someone can ask, why should I utilize an arbitrary bit length? I know that there are 32-bit CPUs and 64-bit CPU. Why to utilize, for example, for 72-bit CPU? Because we are moving towards customization of the hardware in order to achieve even better performance. So for some projects, we don't like to use the standard 32-bit or 64-bit adder. So we would like to use another kind of bit that is suitable for our project. It's like when you like to buy some a suit. You can, of course, buy some suit with standard clothes. You can buy suits with standard numbers. But if you go to a tailor and gives you a custom suit, especially for your needs, then it's much better. The same thing comes with high-performance computing, which is custom designed to achieve much better performance. The tool is online. I invite you to visit the laboratory's address. It's ARC from architecture.ece, Electrical and Computer Engineering, UOWM, University of Western Macedonia, .gr/HDL, and the next file is cla_add_sub.php. If you only go to /HDL, you are going to see a number of other custom tools that create, let's say, multipliers, carry save adders, and other arithmetic modules that can be freely used and incorporated into other modules. So this is the CLA module, and you can find other as well. It's very easy to use, just a browser. Even from your mobile phone, you input the requirements that you'd like to use, for example, number of bits, whether you are going to use flip-flops for the input-output, which is the registers, basically. The output is the VHDL file, and of course, it's a test bench, because when you are going to use something, you have to be sure that this is correct. The verification is a very important step in the design process. So it would be no good if the tool just gave a VHDL and you have to verify, to validate its correctness by yourself. It also emits a test bench that I'm going to present in the next slides. The backend is utilizes the Python language. This Python language performs all the computations, all the equations required to create the optimized carry look ahead adder for the specified bit and other parameters. And it creates an intermediate format called ASDL. I'm going to show you in some slides, which this is then fed to the compiler that is also is being created by my team. You can visit the site and you can input whatever you like and create the necessary modules. The first module is the CLA Designer. As I told you, is a Python program of many hundreds of lines, because it's not just a few lines. To create modules like this, you have to take into consideration a lot of cases, a lot of corner cases, as we say, extreme cases. For example, what if the user gives, for example, 29 bits? We have to be able to deal with this, not only, for example, standard values late of bits like 8, 32, or 64. The CLA Designer utilizes the equations of propagate and generate for every bit. These equations are found in every textbook. But the implementation is a difficult part. So you can see that the ith bit of propagate carries this equation. It's, as you can see, it's an addition of the ith bit of A input and ith bit of B input. And also the generate bit of the ith bit, which also consists of this equation. But the implementation of this equation, as the bits progress, it expands. For example, we can see here for the carry of ith plus 4, we have this equation, which basically means that the carry in propagate bit is always dependent on the first carry input and on the input bits that are known when we start the addition at the first step. So we don't have this chain of carries. I'm going to move a bit ahead because I want to keep the 17 minutes break. Outputs of the CLA designer, it's a JSON file in 8A SDL format. This is a format that my compiler utilizes. It has been published some years ago, how this format can describe a 3D space with all the dependencies and all the modules of a digital circuit. And then this file is input to the SDL compiler tool that creates the VSDL description and the test benches. The SDL compiler consists of multiple stages. The most important are the port mapping and the generation of the HDL. About the ALF-A HDL format, this is a 3D space format. We have for each digital component, three dimensions, X, Y, Z. And for every component, we give the inputs and the outputs. As we can see here, input vector 1, 2, n, and end. And the tool calculates all the necessary, for example, bit widths, because sometimes we want to connect the output of one output to the input of the next level, which is one bit or multiple bits. Or sometimes we want to split this. We have, for example, 10 bits on the output, the 5 bits go to another module, the 5 bits to another module. And all these are described in this format. This format is only used by my tool. It's not an industrial format, but this format, if someone creates a generator for this format, it can utilize my SDL compiler to have a correct VSDL code at the end. The stages of the SDL generator tool. And also the test bench is very important. My tool creates the VSDL of RTL type, register transfer level, and also a test file to verify its correctness. And it verify automatically the correctness of this. It's not just some template or sample test benches. It's specifically generated for the given circuit. And let's move a bit to the next slides. The outputs of the tool. The generator log file that reports how many components it has used. The JSON file, as I told you, in ASDL language, the VSDL file, the VSDL test bench, schematic and block schematic. And I'm going to show you all these files to have a grasp of what it creates. For example, if you now connect to the browser and execute the tool, just press generate, you will see a listing like this. It has important information of, for example, what it has used and in what components. The JSON file format of HDL, it's an array actually of embedded arrays that define all components. Every component has a random ID, which follows the interconnection table that connects every component with every other component. This is an array that is generated automatically. You don't have to write stuff like this, but if you understand if you read my previous paper about alpha HDL format, you can create generators to emit such JSON tables. And if you feed that table into my HDL compiler, you can get the VSDL format like this. This is automatically generated. It's important to know that it's human readable. It's very important because we target also students and engineers. So one of the key issues was to create human readable VSDL format and not like other VHDL generators that you cannot understand anything. Here you can see it's human readable. Of course, this is only a sample of lines, it's not the full VHDL. The automatic testing consists of assert values, assert tests. For example, here it says if they random values, all these words with random function. If we add this, for example, these two inputs, we have to have this output. These are files, signed files, signed values. So we have overflow, and for this reason, we have the output 38. And you just import this into your VHDL simulator, and automatically, either it says test bench okay, if the operation complete successfully, if the correct result is found, or otherwise it reports test bench fail on this value. So someone can just import this, press simulate, and he'll get either the okay or pass or fail value. But of course it does not emit fail because every time is correct. We have made extensive number of experiments. This is the block schematic that shows the input and the output and the stages that all these computations pass through. It's just a visual representation in order to find the critical path for the designer, know where his focus, where he should place his focus. And the conclusions, it's a tool to design custom CLA device. It's on the cloud, it's freely available, it's on the website. You can visit this tool. Do use our tool, give us feedback and comments. It has no restrictions, reliable, and it creates the most important, the VHDL file and the test bench that you can download it and use it on your own project or as a teaching aid if you are on the digital design teaching course. Thank you for watching. My email is this. If you like further information or discussion or perhaps collaboration on issues like this. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Dasigenis. Are there any questions about this interesting topic? I have a question. You said about Python computer language. Do you implement it in other computer languages or only to Python?
Well, it utilizes only Python because it's a fast prototyping language. Of course, there is a delay in some computations, especially if you request modules with thousands of gates. You can see a significant delay because Python is much lower than C. Parts of the Python have been compiled to C using tools of Python, but the most part is Python. And this is a choice because it allows also teams of my members of our my team to contribute to the code, because Python, it's much easier to contribute code than any other language.
Okay, thank you for your reply. Are there any questions? I want to thank Professor Dasigenis for the presentation. And now